How glory the assembled devotees. Jai Sri Sri Guru and Gauranga. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 10, Chapter 10, Text 37. Deliverance of the Yamala Arjun Trees. Anujanihi Nau Bhumams Tavanuchara Kinkarao Darshanam Nau Bhagavata Rishir Asid Anugrahat Anujanihi Nau Bhumams Tavanuchara Kinkarao Darshanam Nau Bhagavata Rishir Asid Anugrahat Anujanihi now bhumams Tavanuchara king karao Darshanam now Bhagavata Rishirasit anugrahat Anujanihi now bhumams Tavanuchara king karao Darshanam now Bhagavata Rishirasid Anugrahat. Anujanihi now Bhumams Tavanuchara Kinkarao Darshanam now Bhagavata Rishirasid Anugrahat. Anujanihi now Bhumams Tavanuchara Kinkarao Darshanam now Bhagavata Rishir Asid Anugrahat. Anujanihi now Bhumams Tavanuchara Kinkarao Darshanam now Bhagavata Rishirasid Anugrahat. Anujanihi now Bhumams Tavanukinkarao Darshanam now Bhagavata Rishirasid Anugrahat. Matajis. Anujanihi now Bhumams Tavanuchara Kinkarao Darshanam now Bhagavata Rishirasid Anugrahat. Anujanihi. May we have permission. Now we, Bhuman, O greatest universal form, Tava Anuchara King Karao, because of being servants of your most confidential devotee, Narada Muni, Darshanam, to see personally, now of us, Bhagavata, of you, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Rishay, of the great Saint Narada, Asit, there was in the form of a curse. Anugrahat, from the mercy. Translation, O Supreme Form, we are always servants of your servants, especially of Narada Muni. Now give us permission to leave for our home. It is by the grace and mercy of Narada Muni that we have been able to see you face to face. Purport by Srila Prabhupada. Unless delivered or blessed by a devotee, one cannot realize that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Manusyanam sahasresu kaschid yatiti siddhaye. According to this verse of Bhagavad Gita, there are so many siddhas or yogis who cannot understand Krishna. Instead, they misunderstand him. But if one takes shelter of a devotee descending from the parampara system of Narada, Swayambhur Narada Shambhu, one can then understand who is an incarnation of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. In this age, many pseudo-incarnations are advertised simply for having exhibited some magical performances. But except for persons who are servants of Narada and other servants of Krishna, no one can understand who is God and who is not. This is confirmed by Narottam Das Thakur, Chadiya Vaishnava Seva Nistara Payecha Keba. No one is delivered from the material conception of life unless favored by a Vaishnava. Others can never understand, neither by speculation nor by any other bodily or mental gymnastics. Anujanihi nau bhumam stavanu chara king karau darshanam nau bhagavato rishara siddha anugrahat. O Supreme Form, we are always servants of your servants, especially of Narada Muni. Now give us permission to leave for our home. It is by the grace and mercy of Narada Muni that we have been able to see you face to face. Om agyanat mirandasya agyananjana shalakaya Chaksurun Militam Jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Nama. I was born in the darkness of ignorance, and my spiritual master opened my eyes with the torchlight of knowledge. I offer my respectful obeisances unto his lotus feet. So here, the pure devotee of the Lord is referred to as servant of the servant. Anuchara king, tava anuchara king karau, servants of your most confidential devotee, servant of the servant, Prabhupada says in the translation. Our senior god brother, who passed away some time ago, guru of few disciples here, he just had his appearance day. Disappearance Day, commemoration. Tamal Krishna Goswami, he wrote one book, Servant of the Servant, and it was all about Prabhupada. Of course, it's all about him also, and about us also, that we are servants of the servant of the servant. And Srila Prabhupada, he posed himself as servant of the servant. Prabhupada never claimed to be someone that had some mystical power and was very special or an incarnation. When devotees were claiming that Srila Prabhupada was an incarnation, he banned them from the movement. I believe it was the late 60s, four nice devotees who came back. Prabhupada sent them away for 6 months when they were making some propaganda that Srila Prabhupada was the personality of Godhead. Prabhupada banned them from the movement, isn't it? In the history, I wasn't here then. I was just a little boy, but this is the history of our ISKCON society. So Prabhupada always posed himself as servant of the servant. Nowadays, everyone is posing themselves incarnation. Myself, Naikatma, Madhurika, I think Loka, went to Utah a few years ago, and we were hired to do kirtan at a movie theater in Salt Lake City for an organization that claimed their guru was the incarnation of Lord Kapila. He was some kind of god. Of course, they loved chanting and they loved dancing. A whole movie theater full of 600 people were chanting and dancing. But they came up to us and they said, please, if you won't chant Hare Krishna so much, there's another mantra. It goes, I'm a Bhagavan, I'm a Bhagavan, I'm a Bhagavan, Hare Hare. I think we did it once and Naikatma gave me a dirty look, I stopped. Isn't it? Maybe we chanted it twice. Thinking that this personality and his spouse were some kind of incarnation. And they had a very special meditation. Their sannyasi would get up on the stage after the kirtan and he would start laughing for a long time. Not like laughing a giggle but he was insanely laughing like someone who should be put in a mental institution. And then I believe part of it was after the laughing, there was crying. And then hopping on their seats and many, many different gymnastics. Prabhupada points out here, bodily and mental gymnastics. We're not about that bodily and mental gymnastics. They were levitating. They were bouncing in their chairs. And they called it levitation. They were laughing and they were crying. We were selling CDs of kirtan, Hare Krishna, ISKCON, kirtan. But I think Naikatma actually walked out of the auditorium at the middle of the laughing and crying. I was selling CDs in the back. But so many organizations, so many people, they're claiming this one is God. One guru, they asked us to play kirtan for their organization. And he gave everyone in the band a deity. I got a deity of Lakshmi Narayan. And it said on the back, made in India. It came right out of his sleeve. He had these super long sleeves. I think he's coming back to America this year. And everybody got a gift. So I went up to one of his senior people after our kirtan. And I said, Gurudev gave us this gift. Was it in his sleeve and he took it out of his suitcase and put it there before the darshan? They said, no. He produced it. He has the power. to produce vibhuti. Actually, we went with him once to Toronto, and he brought all these little bags of vibhuti. And they were in little plastic bags in his suitcase, thousands of little bags of vibhuti. So the customs pulled us aside and locked us up because they thought we had some kind of cocaine or something. And somehow or other, after 2 or 3 hours of being detained in Canada, they somehow believed it was vibhuti that came, that he produced. So I asked them, how is he, where did this come from? They said he produced it. I said, well, here's an interesting point. My deity says on the bottom, made in India. And so-and-so's ring that they got from him says on the bottom or inside somewhere, inscribed, 14 kt or 22 kt, 14 carats. Gold. I said, does he produce them and also put some advertisement and some descriptions? Just like if he produced some food, it would have 10 carbohydrates, 3 sugars, 5 protein. I mean, where's he producing? They said, no, no, he doesn't produce it from nothing. He takes it from one place and brings it to this place. I said, so these items were kind of like at a bazaar, Lloyd Bazaar, or, and he got it off the table and now it's here and it's no longer there. And they said, yeah, that's exactly how he does it. I said, well, there are people that do that. But they call that the, what do they call, five-finger discount. That's called stealing. His mystical power was, so-called, I steal from here to give you a freebie here. They were saying he steals from a table in India. He probably filled up his suitcase in India and has the sleeves with pockets in them and all kinds of things. We're not interested in that kind of gymnastics. Prabhupada never came forward with that kind. Even John Lennon asked Srila Prabhupada and his wife, Zap us, Swami, show us your miracle. And Prabhupada always said, my only miracle is that I've taken all of these hippies and turned them into happies. Taken degenerates, basically speaking, I speak for myself, taking very degraded persons and turning them into Vaishnavas. That's a miracle. No miracle of producing some food or producing something. This is mental gymnastics at best. It's probably trickery. 99%. But they're making some show, and they're making some show of physical gymnastics. We're not interested in all of these things. Mental gymnastics, physical gymnastics. Of course, for one's health, one can perform the physical process of Hatha Yoga, as well as go to LA Fitness and lift weights and sit in the sauna. There is exercise for the body to keep body and soul together. Our Vaishnav sports are actually wrestling and swimming, I was always told. So we have to follow, as these great servants were following, in the footsteps of the great Acharya. We don't concoct anything. Krishna consciousness means, fifth canto of Bhagavatam states, there's no alteration, no addition, and no amendment to what Srila Prabhupada and Krishna and his predecessor Acharyas have given us. They've given the process. They've given the system. We don't change it. Because Prabhupada said, that is your disease, you American boys and girls. You want to change everything. Prabhupada taught us, you talk on the phone or you meet a devotee, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. All glories to Sri Guru and Gauranga. Some old devotee called me up the other day. He used to be a leader in ISKCON, no more. And I said, oh, so-and-so, please accept my humble obeisances. And he responded, namaste. I was like, namaste. I worship the light in you too, but what about Prabhupada and Krishna? What about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? What about that we're servants of the servant? Nowadays, many devotees like to say, Dandavat Pranam. That was not what Srila Prabhupada taught us as greeting and as obeisances. That's from some Gaudiya Math or someplace else. Our ISKCON is, please accept my humble obeisances. You can also write PAMHO, PAMHO, AGTSP, all glories to Srila Prabhupada. And at the end of your email, YS, your servant. Maybe that's allowed. But no changing. Why we want to change? Why give some different? 50 years from now, who knows what people will say? Hallelujah. I worship the light within you. We are servants of the servant. Therefore, we follow the servant. Guru Sadhu Shastra Vaikya Chite Te Kuriya Aikya. Our formula is, if our guru has said it, has given it, if the Shastra has given it, and the sadhu predecessor acharyas have given it, then we accept it. Otherwise, there's no need. Therefore, we should be very careful that we study Srila Prabhupada's books over and over and over. Srimad Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita, Nectar of Devotion, Teachings of Lord Chaitanya, Krishna book, Bhagavad Gita, over and over and over. Learn the verses. There's no need for any other literature, or literature that was translated by someone outside of ISKCON. We quote Srila Prabhupada. We quote Srila Prabhupada's books, which are the law books for the next 10,000 years. Otherwise, who knows what we'll be reading 20 years from now. Every Prabhupada disciple will be finished. Know for a fact. Except for Amala Bhakta. He'll still be here around the corner, 122 years old, whatever he is. In a basket, they'll carry him on your... The rest of us, 25 years, finished, is over. Will you keep the same teachings that Srila Prabhupada gave in his books? Or will you be influenced by the world of yoga? Namaste, Prabhu. Will you become a Hindu and read all the Hindu books? Prabhupada was not a Hindu. Prabhupada didn't give us Hindu sacrifices. He gave us Krishna consciousness. We're not Hindus. That doesn't even exist. It's a name for people on the other side of the Sindus River that was given by the Muslims, the Hindus. We're not a Hindu organization. We're not a yoga, hatha yoga organization. We are bhakti organization. We are Vaishnavas, servants of the servant of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Radasa Muni Tanra Dasa Radas. I'm a servant of Lord Chaitanya. I'm a servant of Lord Chaitanya. I'm a servant of Lord Chaitanya and a servant of his servant's servant. This is in Chaitanya Charitamrita. I'm servant of Lord Chaitanya. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mission. We have to make sure that we keep kirtan. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's kirtan. We don't do Bollywood kirtan. Of course, there are no hard and fast rules for kirtan. You can chant in any manner. But Srila Prabhupada has given us the way and the mood to perform bhajan and kirtan. Nowadays, the kirtaniers of the Mayavadi world, not devotees, they're saying, oh, I composed this kirtan. I composed this tune. They stole some tune from a Bollywood song, and that's their composition. And they're singing it at 45 and a fifth. So slow, you can't even stop thinking. Srila Prabhupada taught us how to chant. He taught us how to increase the speed of the kirtan, how to chant as a Vaishnava. So we don't concoct, we don't change. In 20 years, if we concoct, sense gratification means the concoction of sense gratification. If we change, we'll be chanting using tunes from some heavy metal band or some crazy. Of course, sometimes devotees chant to attract so many people. But basically, we have our disciplic succession and our ways of chanting the Hare Krishna mantra. We used to go as temple bhajavan to a lot of yoga studios. And several places that we went, even recently, they said, could you please not chant so much Hare Krishna? I was like, what? We were in Boston. One lady, big donor for Mayavadi Kirtan, big. Madhurika was there with Banabhatta Prabhu. And she said, yeah, please. I hate it when people chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. I was like, I looked at her, like, what's wrong with you? She said, please chant Shiva, 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 Shambho, Mahadeva, Shambho, Durga, 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 Ama, Ma, 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 Ma. Unfortunately, we learned some of those mantras of the Mayavadis. They chant, Ama, Ma, 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 Ma. After a while, it was ringing in my ears. I was, okay, I got to stop this. We got to go back to the temple. This is ridiculous. Chanting to Durga. Durga, please accept me. Ganesh, please bless me. Chanting to everyone, but whatever you do, don't chant Hare Krishna. They were frightened. Because if you chant, if you approach Krishna, Nivritta Trishna Upagiya Mahanad, Babasada Chotra, Manobi Ramat, Ka Uttama Shloka Kunanuvadat, Puman Birajeta, Vigna Pasugnat. You can't chant Hare Krishna and be a Pasugnat, a killer of the soul, a killer of animals. You can't chant Hare Krishna and be full of mundane philosophical speculation. You have to surrender to Krishna and become the servant of his servant. Then Bhavasada Chotra, Enache Osodi Maya, the medicine of Krishna Katha, the medicine of the Hare Krishna mantra will work. It'll act on you. Just like if you take the antibiotic, it will cure your infection. Of course, it may cause death, chills, vomiting, insanity, and impairment for the rest of your life, which is announced every time they give you some pill. Isn't it, Druda? May cause severe shaking and upset stomach. The medicine that they're giving in this material world has worse side effects than the actual disease. One brother of one devotee, he got a kidney transplant and they put him on the anti-rejection. And he wasn't taking well to the anti-rejection medicine. And from the anti-rejection medicine, he developed in a few years, I think it was called leukemia, a cancer of the bones, bone marrow, and passed away at a very young age. And they were sure, even in the news, one famous actor, I forget his name, big actor, he went in for a routine procedure. Outpatient means They cut you up and send you home the same day. There were complications and he passed away. Didn't go home that night. Passed away from complications. I even asked one doctor, I said, seems like about 80% of the time, whenever there's a procedure, there's complications. And he started walking out of the room. He said, oh yeah, and disappeared. But this medicine, Enecheo Sodimaya, Nasi Barolagi, Hari Nama Maha Mantra, there's no side effect, derogatory side effect, ill side effect. We don't say, chant Hare Krishna, but beware, you might get dizzy, you might gain weight, lose weight, become nauseous. No, you take this medicine, Hari Nama Maha Mantra. The only thing you have to beware is all your material desires will go away. And you'll be in love with Krishna and Radha and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and the spiritual master. And you'll start chanting incessantly, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So this is our medicine. We take this process very seriously. We follow the predecessor acharyas, servant of the servant. We're not interested in mental and physical gymnastics. We're not interested in the Mayavadi philosophy. We do not want to be influenced by their association. We want to give them our association. Therefore, we should be very careful. We don't take up the impersonal path. We don't take up the path of the thinking one person, one common person is God. We follow in the footsteps of the predecessor acharyas. We try to become the servant of the servant. All glories, Sri Guru and Gauranga. We are having a yajna, ISKCON authorized yajna now. So we'll have to talk, unless you have a quick correction.
I want to thank you for bringing up this kirtan point. After all, we are the Hare Krishna movement. So the way and the manner in which we chant Hare Krishna is very important. Yesterday, I got an email from somebody directing me to a website that I don't usually go to because I don't know the truth of their articles or not. But this particular article said that Shiva Ram Swami won't go to the kirtan mailas anymore because he doesn't like the manner in which they chant. So I responded to that two things. You know, Naikatma knows, in the 70s at the Mayapur Festival, we used to have a kirtan competition. They used to invite all these kirtan groups from all over, and they would come and they would sing so sweetly and so emotionally, and then Prabhupada stopped it. He said, no, we're not about a competition. And then one other time, Prabhupada said, when we go out chanting, we are not necessarily trying to impress the audience with our musical capability. They should be left with an impression of devotion to Krishna. So I said, those two things I can say. Otherwise, I'm not going to get into a controversy, but Prabhupada did mention those two things.
In 1975, we were in Chicago, and the president of the temple there was a very wonderful singer, very amazing personality, a friend still to this day, good devotee. But he had one idea that he concocted, that we'd all play kartals in this kind of like marching band form. Naikatma was there with, we were together. And he would sing the Guru Charanapadma prayers, the Guru Puja. And it was extremely timed. It was a whole musical performance. So we went to Mayapur that year, 75. And there were sannyasis there. One sannyasi in particular, who is now the president in Orlando, wonderful sannyasi, but he really can't sing at all. His voice is just a little off. Materially speaking, he can't keep a tune. Wonderful devotee. We love him dearly. So we went up, the Chicago devotees, in Mayapur. Prabhupada was there, 1975. Sri Guru Cha. And the leader, I wasn't the leader. The leader started to do the performance. Isn't it, Naikatma? And Srila Prabhupada stopped the kirtan. We were like shocked. We were in the middle of... We were keeping our time. We were the marching Krishna, the Chicago band. We had it down. And Prabhupada motioned for this Swami who literally could not keep a tune. I know him well. And he knows he can't keep a tune. And Prabhupada stopped the kirtan and brought this sannyasi to finish up the kirtan. In 1977, I was with Tamal Krishna Goswami in Vrindavan in September, serving Srila Prabhupada. And one night, there was a devotee chanting, so beautiful. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. And I thought, wow. I was like, we were in Prabhupada's room. I was fanning Prabhupada. I was thinking, this is just amazing. And Prabhupada said, very clearly, this was 2 months before he passed, who is that Rakshasa? He's thinking my voice is so pretty. I was shocked. I thought, wow, I better be careful. Fanning Prabhupada with the yak tail fan. And Tamal Krishna Maharaj explained, it's such and such das. And Prabhupada said, tell him not to chant like that. So, yeah, Archita's right. All glories to Sri Guru and Gauranga. Time for Hindu Yajna.